Hello, it's me, Eugenija, with project Heart Over Me, and today I have Reece to talk with, who says about himself, his essence is nothing and everything. You can and can't describe it. I am wholeness. He's a lifestyle self-development coach and uses all types of breathwork to help others access the love within themselves to heal. He contributes to the world by sharing his tools, words, experiences for the collective consciousness to raise up. So, in the beginning of our conversation, can you please say where we can find you? Do you have a webpage? Do you have Instagram? And how to find it? And then we will go on in the conversation with you.
Sure. So I have my Instagram, is the first thing. My Instagram is at the name of Pranic Strength. So Pranic being P-R-A-N-I-C and then strength. Same with the website. The website is www.pranicstrength.com. And if you want to access my YouTube, where I put some follow along videos, you can also find it at the same name, Pranic Strength.
Okay. Can you please introduce yourself? Who are you? What are you doing in your life? And I know you're following your heart, so it was not always like that. So first, who are you?
My name is Reece Jordan Dunn. And who I am, great question. I am somebody who loves to follow my heart, really, and follow my intuition and take risks. And sometimes express myself like a baby and have a tantrum. Sometimes get really, really serious and execute, and sometimes just create. So that's who I am.
You are from UK?
Yeah, I'm from the UK. I'm from London. Actually, a little bit outside of London in West Essex or Southeast Essex.
And you're traveling around and right now landed in Kuwait. What are you
doing? Yes. In Kuwait, I am lifestyle coaching. And in lifestyle coaching, it's been an interesting journey, really, because I use breathwork as a tool for people to access deeper layers of themselves. So what I do isn't on a surface level only of physical, but it really gets into the iceberg layers of the mental, emotional and the spiritual as well. And anyone that's trying to, you know, establish new habits in their life and new ways of being is how we reprogram this with funky breath work and body mind activation games.
How did it happen to your world, you know, in your life? How did it happen?
It did. I would definitely say it happened very organically. And it came through me moving to Kuwait some years back, 3 or 4 years ago. And I was just in a very masculine energy. And I'd definitely had some mindfulness and consciousness to me at that time when I came 4 years ago, because I've been vegan or plant-based. I'm not really into labels, but vegan for nearly 6 years now. So there was this consciousness inside me when I came here. That being said, I didn't have a practice that was so feminine, and I hadn't explored that place before. And had great meditation in Vietnam one time. Living in Kuwait has really given me the blessing to travel and just, you know, the Middle East is literally the middle of the map. So I can
go everywhere. Perfect. I love it.
Yeah. So
what happened in Vietnam?
Boom. Vietnam, I had a beautiful meditation in the rice field in this bamboo hut. And I, for the first time, allowed myself to allow my breath to just do what it does, just to breathe. Yeah. It's an unconscious and conscious mechanism. So I allowed it to unconsciously do his thing and just focus on that. And what I began to notice was, as the breath does its thing inside my mouth, my tongue was just kind of making this wave action on each breath.
Yeah.
And I was just pretty mesmerized by this, because I didn't get too excited, but I noticed when my tongue would reach the roof of my mouth and it would just kind of lift to here.
Yeah.
In this hard palate point, I felt that there was this, with my eyes closed, this spark that would happen every time it touched.
It was
very powerful. And after that meditation, I just found myself obsessed with researching, what is this breath? What is it? How does it work? How do I access it deeper? The first time noticing, you know, a subtle mechanism of the breath and what it does for the system and how it made me feel inside, really. So I was just on my laptop all the time, just like, I want to know more about this breath. I'm going to find some books.
But it happens then. Then you're coming back. You are getting the technique. And then you're coming back to Kuwait, to your work.
To my work. No, I was in the gym, and the gym was a very masculine place, and I noticed everything in my emotional body and mental body becoming more sensitive.
Yeah.
Energy work, I just felt my energy more sensitive. So coming back to Kuwait, I integrated it with my calisthenics coaching, which is what I was doing full time in that gym. And this is still something I teach people through now, integrating with the breath.
Yeah.
I noticed that the progress with people when I taught them how to breathe and then do the strength work was like, it was just, people were just progressing quickly. So I had this man, and he was early 50s, and he had been stuck on 3 pull-ups as his maximum for maybe 9 months or 10 months.
Yeah.
And I showed him how to breathe from his diaphragm, and within 1 week from that day, he increased his maximum pull-ups from 3 to about 7 or 8.
Wow. Okay, please go back a little bit. When it happened, you are coming back from Vietnam, you are going to your gym, back to your work, quite masculine, and you have a bit masculine energy where you have to motivate, and then you feel that you are not the same.
Correct.
Do you start to changing the gym and saying, maybe we can make another new technologies to start using something different, or you just feel you have to leave?
My life. Oh, that's an interesting question. My life.
You are in Vietnam. You are getting yeah. And I remember, because when I was young, I was always in the gyms, you know, and I know it is no time, you're coming, there is like techno music, boom, 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 and power, you do it. So it is no time for breathing, you know. And then you see, if nowadays we have some, like another studios, like, you know, better Pilates and yoga and another stuff, where it's more slowly, but you don't see men there, or at least a couple of men. And now you're talking about another kind of gyms where men, and I can imagine it was there. So it is like, you know, how you're going to change, and you see, wow, okay, I can push my body, but not that much. It could be, we can work out in harmony with our body, like, you know, breathe.
Yes.
And it means it changes a lot of the whole movement. Like yes.
Rhythm of, and the rhythm as well, the rhythm of the class changes too.
Yeah.
So what comes to me when you say this, within 2 months of coming back from Vietnam, there was like a monthly event at the gym, and on the last day of the monthly event, everyone comes in to the gym that was doing this kind of competition. For getting the most amount of calories per month. And they had this spin class, which is the biking class, stationary bikes. And I wasn't coaching and I wasn't physically participating. But so I entered the room and the music was like, yeah, maybe, I don't know, maybe like 160 or 170 beats per minute. And I wasn't moving my body, and I had to leave the room because I felt my heart was like, I'd been breathing calmly for 2 months, and I went outside and felt I was having a panic attack or something, and I really needed a breather. And that confirmed to me that the gym environment isn't for me at this point in time. And it was really eye-opening for me because I'd never had anything like that.
The gyms, and the most of the gyms, they don't have even windows. They are like, you know, you're going in a space in a block where they have the machines or you can rent, and there's a lot of electricity around, like, you know, TV. Now nowadays, like, you know, each almost machine, it has one TV, and you know, like, where you really you are completely disconnected in electronic world around you, and just doing exercise, just muscle, move.
Yeah.
And so, did you have also the same?
Yeah, it definitely had a lot of electronics in there. Not like a normal gym though, because it was more functional training. So it was definitely less electronics than in most gyms, to be honest. Yeah. Not many machines is what I'm saying. But it was closed. It was like a box, and it was dark, and it was not, it was like a cave. So wasn't really a place where I could feel vibrant as I wanted to be.
Okay. So what you do after, okay, you realize you don't resonate anymore with your working environment. So what do you do? And how long it took time to change something? Because now I know you are like, you know, you have your own company. So how was the shift? Because that's exactly the main point why I'm doing interviews. How you are doing, you are going your life, and suddenly you don't resonate, but you are scared, you have fears. So how do you make this step?
So when I came back from Vietnam, within 6 months, I began to feel in those 6 months from coming back that everything was pulling me, the universe, God, this higher energetic force was doing everything to me to tell me, don't be here anymore. Go move forward and be in an environment that you create. And after so many challenges, which I'm happy because they manifest as lessons too, I said, look, I need to leave this place. And out there, it looks like very uncomfortable for me to be a freelancer and for me to create a company and start something new, the unknown. But in that unknown, if I'm uncomfortable by the idea of it, that's probably where I should go. That's probably what I should do next. Because on the other side of discomfort is greatness. And every time we leave our comfort zone, and I'll say it in my own experience, every time I take a risk and leave my comfort zone, and at the same time, follow my heart when doing that, and it all aligns, it never lets me down, because there's always a lesson to learn in those choices in our life. So I I broke my toe like 2 weeks before leaving the company, and it was like, my body doesn't work now, and my body is my job. And I was just, you know, the doctor in the hospital after the x-ray, he strapped my toes together, right? Mm-hmm. And before I'd left the hospital, I just ripped them off. I said, I can heal this myself. I am positive and I'm firm in myself that I know how to do this. And massaged my feet for a week, and I did some like self-massage from some Chinese medicine that I'd learned. Went back a week later to the hospital. Mm-hmm. And the doctor said to me that I'm making a miraculous recovery. So the toe wasn't completely healed. It wasn't like a so quickly, but the progress and the stability and the support and the swelling had all just...
It was done. How many percentage it was healed?
How much percent it was healed? Between 70 and 80% in 1 week. And they said in 4 weeks, it will be healed. 4 to 6 weeks, it will be maybe I can walk, you know? But I walked into the room after a week.
Wow. So it is this is about how did you heal yourself. Let's talk about, because now we are to the feet, about the feet, barefoot. You started walking exactly in this moment, I think, when you break it. And then what happened? What you do now?
Okay. So before I broke my toe, I had been diagnosed chronically barefoot.
Barefoot.
Bring it back. Before... we all are chronically barefoot, right? I was diagnosed
because of the shoe. We have forgotten being that having this disease because of the shoes.
Because of the shoes, right? So I'd been diagnosed for my whole life, like as long as I had known, really, even in my athletic career, flat feet was something that I always had.
Yeah.
Okay. And I never took care of my feet, ever. I never took care of them. But I felt this feeling inside me from taking that strap off and healing my foot that my feet are so important. I found a new love for them.
Yeah.
Began to do lots of research and noticing that barefoot is the best way to be. And there were so many initiatives pushing it. And I began to walk on the grass a couple times a day, on the beach a couple times a day. I was continuing doing my routine, which actually helped me heal. And I was healed the broken toe. I'm continuing doing that until this day. And it's the self foot massage, which also I can send a video in to you to put for a link after this as well.
Yeah, with a great pleasure. How do you sell for the world now? Because what kind of services offering your company?
Boom, 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 boom. So it's all wellness. It's complete and whole package of wellness. So I deal with the physical on a masculine and feminine perspective. So we do things that are very push, masculine, strength work, gymnastics rings. I do quite a sensual practice, which is movement practices and allowing the body to be strong and flexible. And then I do more of a feminine physical practice like yoga, qigong, and these kind of things. And then on a mental level and emotional level, I work through journaling. So, you know, this is where we establish new habits. And we establish our intentions and we express our emotions. And journaling is one of the tools I use. And then if people's intention is also on a spiritual level, we go many layers deeper into that, about healing traumas and allowing what no longer serves us to release from an ancestral level, from our personal experiences, and just diving in.
That's very, very deep what you're offering. It is very deep.
Yes, it's whole. It should be whole. Our system cannot be compartmentalized completely. At least in my view.
Now I'm in France and you are in Kuwait.
Yes.
How do you work? Do you work with clients in Kuwait, or you also work with over the world? How we can connect to you?
Mm.
And what kind of people usually you are coaching?
Good question. Okay, I'll start with what kind of people am I coaching. So who is coming to me at the moment? Young entrepreneurs that are newly setting up businesses and have realized that the game of getting their own routine right is a big part of getting the company right. So young entrepreneurs, and then already established CEOs who are in this energy of wanting to come back to, or to return, I should say, to their wellness. So the two types of people that I'm getting are young entrepreneurs and established CEOs. That being said, who am I aiming for? I am aiming for any people who have a progressive mindset, a mindset that wants to grow, that wants to push forward, that wants to allow themselves to flourish in a way and just open up. And so if the person is in the category of wanting to grow, then they are in my client ideal.
And how do they can reach to you?
Okay, so online? Before I go for the reaching, you asked me before, I want to cover that one, about where do I do and what do I do. So I do one-to-one PTs, private training, private coaching in Kuwait, and I do many breathwork group classes in Kuwait as well. Workshops around the Middle East and outside of the Middle East, if I'm traveling to that place or upon request from that place as well. So I love to do workshops and masterclasses. And then back to returning to private coaching, I do one-to-one online as well. So either creating programs for people or for my clients, or doing video call sessions. And this can be reached, or you can reach me via www.pranicstrength.com. Also at my YouTube, you can check out some of the videos. I put more of my philosophy, some of the action videos, and some follow-along breathing exercises too. YouTube is Pranic Strength, the same spelling as this morning, P-R-A-N-I-C, Strength. Mm-hmm. And it's the same for Instagram too.
Perfect.
And you can sign up for my newsletter also via my website.
Thank you so much for your time and sharing this all wisdom, and also miraculous, also to encouraging with your example other person to follow their hearts and to start moving, and then to see that actually it works and the universe starts opening. Also, I would like to invite. Please.
No, I just really felt what you were saying. Yeah.
And I also would like to invite to join our community, Heart Over Me, on Facebook. We have also the webpage, heartoverme.com. Also, we have just since few days YouTube channel, Heart Over Me. So please find, subscribe, follow us. There will be much more. Also with Freeze. I hope to invite you again, and maybe you will share more about breath techniques, because that's very important. Even if we hear about thousands of times, million times, but there is always 1,000th first time when you realize, oh, I have to do it, and you start doing. So thank you so much for your time, and see you next time.
See you.
Yeah. I stopped recording. No, I didn't.